Rüdi, Rüdi!
So once I left Syria, I went to Amman and I started working there. One of the organizations I started working with there is called Tactical Technology Collective, which moved to Berlin. So the Syrian Archive is a project to preserve visual evidence of human rights violations that has been committed in Syria. I mean, you can think about the process of how we collect the videos and archive them and add metadata to it as like the work of an archivist who is doing work in a normal library to analyze this evidence and investigate on it to make sure that it's used right now for journalistic purposes and advocacy and later on for accountability purposes.
Zunächst ist die Dokumentation von Kriegsverbrechen ab dem ersten Moment sehr wichtig, weil über die Jahre natürlich Informationen verloren gehen oder auch Zeugen sich nicht so gut erinnern können mehr. Wir kennen das Syrian Archive und haben uns das auch schon mehrfach angeschaut natürlich. Wir wissen aus der Vergangenheit und vielen anderen Konflikten, dass Verfahren zu Kriegsverbrechen 20, 30, 40 Jahre später auch erst stattfinden können. Das Wichtigste, was das Material betrifft, ist die Möglichkeit, einen weiten Überblick zu kriegen, welche Art von Verbrechen stattgefunden haben, wann, wo und durch wen, um Makroverbrechen, also große Verbrechenskomplexe, anklagen zu können.
So this process goes into verifying the sources. So the people who are giving us the videos is mainly from citizen reporters. They took a video, they published it online. We kind of like saw that, or we contacted them to get the materials. Once this is done, we collect the videos from them and then we go to the next step, which is about verifying the date. We do the verifying the date through cross-referencing the date of the incident where it happened with other human rights reports. The third thing is about geolocating the video. So we make sure that we use satellite imagery from Google Earth or from Wikimapia to compare the footage from the video with the footage from the satellite and understand that this happened actually in Syria, not in another context, not in another area. So the process of verify the video can take few hours into few days. It can sometimes take months. There is definitely a personal loss for every Syrian right now. I mean, no matter which sides he or she is, we have all lost the country, we have all lost people, we have all lost our homes. If you kind of like continue working and watching these videos all the time, you will definitely break down, you will definitely get depressed, you will definitely get so emotional about it and you will cry and so on. I mean, like, the most horrifying thing is not like the videos that I have seen, is that what I am seeing every day. To see this continually happening every day since 2011 until now.